Good afternoon, student. In the previous video, we discussed about clock arithmetic. And we said how we are going to calculate the time in clock. Today, we are going to discuss modular arithmetic. And we are going to define congruent modulo m. We are going to define congruent modulo m. What is the meaning of this? How we are going to work with this congruent modulo m? What are all the applications we can try? This is what we are going to discuss in this video. This is very easy and simple idea. As you know very well about the division and multiplication. See, in the last class, we gave an idea. I'm going to find what is 8 plus 9. In clock arithmetic. So when we say 8 plus 9, we said that we are going to add the two numbers. What is the sum? This will be 8 plus 9 is equal to 17. If the number is above 12, we said that we are going to subtract 12 from the number. If the number is above 12, we said that we are going to subtract 12 from the number. The balance or the remainder will be the answer. So 17 minus 12. So this is 5. So in 12 hours clock arithmetic system, when I add 8 plus 9, then we will be considered as 5. This is depends on anti-meridian or post-meridian, AM or PM. Now, I am going to perform the same in the other way. For example, instead of subtraction, I am going to make 17, I am going to divide by 12. I am going to divide by 12. So, what is the meaning of this? When 17 is divided by 12, so we will have two parts. One part is called quotient. And the other part is called remainder, isn't it? The final answer. So when I divide 17 divided by 12, the quotient will be 1 because 1 multiply 12. 12, the remainder is 1. See, now you can find that when I make 17 minus 12, the answer is 5. Here the remainder is 1. So shall we say instead of subtraction, I am going to make the division and I am going to take the remainder. Shall I say, instead of subtraction, I am going to divide the number by 12 and I am going to check the remainder. This is the basic principle for congruent modulo M. Let me check another problem now. For example, I want to find 11 plus 11 plus 11. Here, I am going to check this. The first number is 11. I am going to add these two numbers, 11 plus 11. So, this is 22. In 12 hours clock arithmetic system, whenever we are having a number above 12, we said that we are going to subtract 12 from the number. So I am having 22. I am going to subtract 12 from the number. So what will be the answer now? This is 11 plus 22 minus 12 is 10. Now, again, I am going to add these two numbers. 11 plus 10 is 21. Again, this number is above 12. This is greater than 12. I am going to subtract 12 from the number. So the final answer is 9. So when I have 11 plus 11 plus 11, I'm going to perform the addition operation. wherever I am getting the number above 12, I am going to subtract the number 12 from the number and I am going to take the remainder. If you check here, we have subtracted 12 two times. Here is one time and here is one time. Here is one time and one time. So here we have subtracted 12 in two times. Now I am going to make it in the other way with the division. What is 11 plus 11 plus 11? This is nothing but 33. Correct? I am going to divide 33 by 12. Now I am going to check what is the quotient and what is the remainder. This is the balance, remainder. So when I divide 33 by 12, this is two times. If you remember last time, we have subtracted two times. 2 multiplied 12 is 24. The remainder is 9. See, again, we are getting the same remainder 9 as the answer. So the basic idea of congruence modulo is nothing but we are going to divide a number and we are going to take the remainder. Please note, the multiple subtraction of a same number is nothing but the division. Multiple subtraction of a same number is called division. So using this idea, we are going to define the congruence modulo. See, now I am going to make the definition for congruence modulo M. What is the meaning of this? I am going to take two integers. Let A and B be two integers. I am going to take a number M which is greater than 1. The definition of congruence modulo M is nothing but A minus B is divisible by M. A minus B is divisible by M. Then this is called congruence modulo M. Or when we divide A by M, the remainder is B. When we divide A by M, the remainder is B. This definition is called congruence modulo. Here we can write this in a notation. Notation is in mathematical way how we can represent the above set statement. Here we are going to write like this. A is congruent to. There is a symbol called congruence. This symbol is called congruence. So you will put equal and a wiggle on the top. Your equal and wiggle on the top is called congruence. A is congruent to B mod M. The idea or the meaning, when I divide A by M, the remainder is B. This is the definition for congruence modulo M. See, dear, now we are going to discuss some problem on congruence modulo M. See, for example, find the value of x if 27 is congruent to x mod 4. Find the value of x if 27 is congruent to x mod 4. What is the meaning of this? We are going to divide 27 by 4 and find the remainder. Find the remainder. Divide 27 by 4 and find the remainder. The remainder value is the x value. The remainder value is the x value. This is called congruent modulo m. So when I divide 27 by 4, I am going to check what is quotient and I am going to check what is the remainder. What is the meaning of quotient? 27 divided by 4. 6 fours are 24. The remainder is 3. Correct? 6 fours are 24. The remainder is 3. So now I can say the value of x is nothing but 3. Now what I can say? The value of x is 3. I am going to write this in the notation again. The notation is nothing but 27 is congruent to 27 is congruent to 3 mod 4. Again, the idea is nothing but when I divide 27 by 4, the remainder is 3. The idea of congruence modulo, I am going to divide the given number by modulo m value and I am going to find the remainder. I am going to divide the number by congruence modulo m value and I am going to find the remainder. This is called congruent modulo m. This is called congruent modulo m. Now shall we discuss one more problem in this idea? Let me go with a small number. Maybe evaluate. Congruent to x on mod 10. 58 is congruent to x mod 10. What is the meaning of this again? I am going to divide 58 by 10 and find the remainder. The value of x is the remainder. So here we will have two values. One is called quotient and the other one is called remainder. So the quotient, when I divide 58 by 10, this is 5 times. The remainder is 8. Correct? 5 times 50, the remainder is 8. So the value of x is nothing but 8. The value of x is nothing but 8. I am going to write this in the notation. So 58 is congruent to, what is the remainder here? 8 on mod 10. 58 is congruent to 8 on mod 10. So this is the introduction for congruent modulo m. This is the introduction for congruent modulo m. In the next class, we will discuss some arithmetic operation on congruent modulo. In the next video, we will discuss some arithmetic operation on congruent modulo. Thank you.